Hello everybody and welcome back to another Satisfactory video, and today we're going to be talking about combat and enemies. And right now I'm going to show you the best way to fight your very first enemy in Satisfactory. Now you'll notice that you see these fluffy tailed hog baby rhino things by your limestone, iron, and copper nodes. They're going to charge you right away. And as soon as they charge you, you're going to jump over it, and you're going to zap it right in the top of the head. And then it's going to charge you again, and you're just going to do that same thing, and you're going to repeat the process. And it'll take exactly four hits from the Xenozapper to kill that baby rhino hog fluffy-tailed guy. Now, something you should know is that the enemies in Satisfactory will never damage or attack your structures that you build. So if you build a factory, you don't have to worry about the enemies attacking your factory. In fact, if you build a factory near the spawn point of enemies, they will not respawn once you kill them. I just want to have a quick shout out to my friend Genesis. She gave me a really cool idea for a call to action for my YouTube videos, and that is going to be a random photo in every video. So I want you to go ahead and just leave a comment down below if you find the random photo. It's going to be a picture of her because she wanted me to do that in this video. So if you find the picture of my friend Genesis in this video, go ahead and leave a comment down below. Now let's take a little bit of a look at the weapons in Satisfactory. We have the Xeno Zapper, or as I like to call it, the Garbage Zapper 1.0. It's garbage, okay? Now, the second weapon in Satisfactory that you should probably unlock as soon as freaking possible, and if you don't yet have it, you need to just pause this video and go unlock that right now and then continue. It's called the Xeno Basher, and it's extremely effective because it does 7 damage on the first hit, and then 14 damage on the second hit, providing a 21 damage combo, killing these fluffy-tailed rhino baby hogs in only 2 hits. If you can land a double combo, one right after the other, otherwise it's not gonna work. Now, something else you can unlock for weaponry is the rebar gun, which you can turn iron rods into rebar. Now, this does 15 damage at a range. Now, that calls for one rebar gun shot, making contact with the fluffy dog, rhino, baby thing, whatever the hell you wanna call it, and one zap. But it would probably just make more sense to shoot it with the rebar gun twice. And then after that, really towards the late game, you unlock the rifle, which does 6 damage per shot, and it comes with 10 rounds per magazine. And somewhere in between unlocking the rifle and the rebar gun, you can potentially unlock something called the Nobelisk, which is like a semi-futuristic World War II style C4, and you just kind of hold this thing in your hand and chuck it at things, blow them up. It does up to 50 damage depending on the range. Now, there are exactly 6 different types of enemies in Satisfactory, and if you want to take down to a subcategory of spiders, there are approximately 10 different types of enemies that you could come into contact with in Satisfactory. If you've learned something new in this video already, go ahead and leave me a subscribe, because I'm going to be making a ton more content that's like this, and you'll probably like my future videos. We have the baby rhino hogs, which you'll find in the early game around the basic resource nodes. You have the alpha hogs, which are a beefed up mama version of the baby rhino hogs, as I like to call them. And these guys you'll more so find near crash sites or yellow power slugs. We also have the spitters, which, as you can guess, they spit fire. These guys are not fun, and very hard to fight. Sometimes. And then, after those guys, we have the Alpha Spitters, which, just like last time with the Alpha Hog, is a beefed up mama version of the Spitter. Now, the cool thing about these Alpha Spitters is that they come in 2 different variants. There's a red one and a green one. If you see a green one and you don't have a Xeno Basher, you better fucking run. Now, the red one, as I hopefully made it fairly aware, is a little bit less hard to fight than the green one. And there's these flies. The Satisfactory Wiki likes to call them crab flies. I fucking hate these things. They're annoying. I hate the sound they make. They give me the heebie-jeebies, but the Xenobasher works pretty well against them. They have 6 HP, so it'll take 2 hits from a Xeno Zapper to kill them, unfortunately. But if you have Xeno Basher, like I told you to get, you won't have an issue. Tip for fighting these guys. Your Xeno Basher swing can only hit one enemy at a time, so don't think, you know, oh, I'm going to line these 3 guys up all at once, take one swing, and kill them all at once. That's not necessarily how it works. That can happen in very rare occasions, but it's very unlikely. Now, last, but most certainly not least, we have spiders. Now, I personally fucking hate these things, and they come in 4 different variants.
Warning, spider images.
They come in tiny, small, large, and elite. Now, as you can imagine, the tiny ones, actually, they don't do anything. The small ones are small and attack you. The large ones are fucking huge and attack you for more. And the elite ones are the same size as the large ones, but they're a little bit of a different, like, kind of green color. And they do ass loads of damage to your Bungholio. It's not fun, and it sucks a lot. Now, before we go into much further detail about specific individual enemies and how to fight them the best way, I want to give you a little bit of information about your health. So you can see that you have 10 squares of health in the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. Each of those squares provides you with 10 HP. That equals out to 100 hit points, or HP. Now, if you happen to lose half a square, a whole square, or even 2 squares, there are ways that you can remedy this. Now, if you lose half a square, the perfect thing for you is going to be this barrel nut, amazing-looking semi-tan-wrapped nutshell with a blue nut inside. Delicious. Now, if you happen to lose a full square of health from one of those pesty baby hog rhino things, charges you right in the face hole, you're going to want to grab a berry. Those adorable pinkish-red, semi-orange-colored things. They look like giant strawberries. Those things are extra delicious, and they give you 10 HP, a full square of health. Now, if you happen to take a few hits or more, a couple hits or more, from one of these baby hog rhino dumb fucks, you're gonna want to find bacon. It actually kind of looks like a mushroom, and it has a stem, and you'll most of the time find it around rivers. All right, let's get into the specifics of the enemies. Now, you have the baby hog or baby rhino hog. I don't know. I like either name. Now, it does 10 damage with its charge attack. Like I said earlier, you can get all of that back with one of your berries. It has 20 hit points. Unlike you, you have 5 times the amount. And it would take exactly 5 hits from the Xeno Zapper, that garbage thing, to kill one of these. Now, an Alpha Hog can do 20 damage with its charge attack, very similar to the Baby Rhino Hog charge attack. And it's very extremely rare, I have never seen this, 30 damage bite melee attack. Like I said, I've never seen this before, but the wiki says that it's a thing, so yeah. Now, the Alpha Hog has 80 hit points. That is only 20 less than you, the engineer player for Fixit Incorporated. That is a lot of hit points. And if you do quick maths, that's 16 Zapperoonies from the fucking Xeno Zapper. That's not good. So like I said, you better have that Xeno Basher. Now, as for the spitters, these guys do 5 to 10 damage, and I believe it's based on distance or range from the spitter. If you're extremely far away, I believe it'll do more damage, and if you're closer, it'll do less. That doesn't make any sense, I know, but I think that's just how it works. Now, these guys have 40 HP, and that is exactly 8 zaps from that crappy Xeno Zapper we keep fucking talking about. Now, for the red alpha spitters, these guys can only do up to 10 damage, which I think is baloney, because I'm pretty sure one has done 30 damage to me before. So we're gonna go with up to 30 damage. These guys have 60 hit points, and that is exactly 12 zaps from the Xeno Zapper. Not quite as many as the Alpha Hog, but the Alpha Hog can't shoot fucking fireballs. For the Alpha Spitter green variant, they can do up to 20 damage, which I also think is baloney, but I haven't fought a whole lot of these guys before, so we'll just go with that. Now they have 80 HP, which is the same as the Alpha Hog, 16 Zapparoonies. And for the flies, they have 6 HP. We talked about them a little bit. And they only do 5 damage. And we haven't really talked about these things before in this video, but I like to call them the fish flowers. These things suck. They spit out nasty poop gas at you and does 5 damage per second. It's pretty terrible, but you can remove it with a Nobilisk explosion. Now, for the spiders, we did talk a little bit about these guys, but the tiny variant, which I've never seen before, doesn't do any damage and only has 5 HP. The small variant has 10 HP and does 10 damage. That's only 2 zaps from the Xeno Zapper. The large variant has 50 HP and does 30 damage. That's 10 zaps from the Xeno Zapper for that 50 hit points. And the elite spider, which I have also never encountered, I'm starting to think I don't know what the hell I'm talking about because I haven't played this game a lot, apparently. It has 100 hit points. That is equivalent to the Walker boss. And it can do 30 damage with its stinger on top of 5 damage per second from its nasty fart sacs inside of its ugly body that you just cannot handle, more than likely, unless you're not grossed out by these things, which I definitely am. So that's pretty brutal. So if you ever encounter a large spider that has a semi-green, kind of blue, a weird color tint, you should probably fucking run, unless you have, like, a rifle or something. I wouldn't even want to fight this thing with a rifle. That's fucking scary. I'm going to give you some good bonus facts, like good-to-know bonus facts about enemies. So, now, something crazy about the enemies in this game is that they can teleport back to their spawn location. For example, if you're fighting a spider and you draw it out of its cave, and you're trying to get it to lunge off the side of a mountain to kill it, that more than likely won't work, and it'll just teleport back to its spawn and regain all of its health. Now, if you're fighting a baby rhino hog, that's a different story. Those things could travel across the entire map and will just continue to chase you, unless you get, you know, a certain distance away from it, then it'll kind of just leave you alone. Another amazing bonus fact is that if you have 100 HP, 99 HP, 98 HP, or 97 HP with Blade Runners, fall damage will not kill you. Fall damage can only do a maximum of 97 damage. Now, try to think about it as this. If I have full health, I can't die to fall damage. Don't think about it in any other way, because if you do, at least in my mind, I tend to jump off cliffs thinking, oh, fall damage doesn't do any damage, I can't die from fall damage, because it only does 97 damage, and then I realize that the second before I hit the ground, and there I go, spending 20 minutes trying to find my crate. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a bit of a different style of video. I kind of wanted to try something new, and also I was kind of crunched on time for this video. So I also kind of wanted to cram lots of information in just a short amount of time. Now, if you like this video, go ahead and leave a like, and if you want more videos exactly like this one, subscribe or leave a comment letting me know that you liked this specific video. I think that in the future, I'll more than likely be doing a beginner's guide rather than a generalized guide to combat and enemies. Now, in that video, the beginner's guide to enemies, it'll more than likely be in-depth combat strategies against beginner enemies like the baby rhino hog and the basic spitter, rather than overcapping every enemy in the game. Sorry, I'm blabbing on. Now, anyways, if you like the video, leave a like. If you want more content like this, please leave a subscribe. Click the bell, or don't, you know, whatever, just you do you. And I'll be seeing you in the next video. Peace! Enjoy these lizard doggos, please!